Good afternoon, friends. I'm Pastor Jeff Schultz, and I serve as the Finance and Administration Team Lead, and I'm with my friend and our director, Ed Walsh. I don't have to tell you that inflation is high, gas is astronomical, and on the flip side, most investments have taken a rather big hit. Financial advisors will tell you, think long term. Jesus said, it is more blessed to give than to receive. He taught that storing up treasures on earth is ultimately not the best strategy. And so when we give to strengthen our ministries in the Eastern region, let me just remind you, we are thinking long term. We are investing in eternity. Thank you for investing your treasure in the treasure of the church and its mission. Thank you for your generosity toward EFCER. I want you to know our transition to Evangelical Friends Missions is going extremely well. EFM is now managing the bulk of our international mission work. Our church has seen several initiatives where they are sponsoring opportunities to raise up new missionaries. And so we encourage you to continue to support EFM. There are two parts of our budget this year. We, again, have the fair share giving, which basically funds our administration. And we have the Great Commission giving, which funds all that we do to support our mission to equip and strengthen the local church. Here are the types of things your Great Commission budget supports. Number one, we fund the recruiting and development of pastors. We support the planning of new churches in the United States. We support revitalization efforts of existing churches. And we support Malone University. And you've heard about some new opportunities with Malone this weekend. We also fund the administrative costs of Evangelical Friends Mission so that they can do what they do best, and that is support mission work abroad. Now, as a team, we work on a lot of things, but the biggest news I think this year is probably the change to our pension plan. This year, we adopted a new 403B plan along with a new company to help us administer it. And this is big because it allows pastors to make additional contributions towards their own retirement in a tax advantageous way. And so, Ed, just help us out for a little bit. What is a 403B plan?
Well, that's a great question, Jeff. And the name's actually taken from the IRS code. So it's from section 403 of the IRS code in paragraph B. And so that is how that's arrived. Now, many of you are familiar with 401k plans. You may have that. 401k plans are for those for-profit companies. 403Bs are plans, they're exactly the same thing, but it's for nonprofits, of which Eastern Region is qualifies. So the reason this is a big deal for Eastern Region is our original plan was established back in 1948, which was great foresight of our leaders back then. But the reality is that Israel became a nation in 1948. So 401ks and 403bs didn't exist. And tax laws prohibited us from converting to these better plans. So the end of 2019, Congress passed legislation that allowed plans like ours to convert to a more favorable 403b. plan. So this plan allows pastors to contribute a portion of their salary tax-free, resulting in tax savings.
So if I make $40,000 a year and I contribute $2,000 of my money to my retirement fund, that means I'm only going to pay taxes on that $38,000. Is that right?
Absolutely.
And as a result, I'm going to save as much as $600 a year.
Which I love.
Which makes a lot of sense and is really, really good. Let me tell you, if you have more questions, Ed loves to talk taxes and tax savings. He is your expert. If you have a question, he's a good guy to talk to.
The pension plan is just one example of Eastern Region's commitment to financially healthy pastors. Another example is Eastern Region's Financial Health Fund. In the past 3 years, the National Association of Evangelicals and the Lilly Foundation have made $65,000 in matching grants to EFCER. That's $130,000 used to help pastors with financial challenges. This has allowed us to make grants of up to $5,000 to pastors to help with paying off student loans or medical expenses that they have. It frees them to concentrate on ministry.
Hey there, everybody. My name is Dominic Mariano. I am the children and family pastor at Alliance Friends Church, and I just wanted to come on here and say thank you to the Eastern Region for the scholarship that I received to help me pay off my student loans. I am so grateful and thankful for this because I had a goal coming out of college last year to pay off my student loans within 2 years of graduating. I mean, I know that seems crazy, but this scholarship has actually helped me achieve this goal sooner than I was anticipating. So I just want to say thank you for that. But I also want to say thank you for the generous life devotional and training that that we offer. This has actually shaped my view on money and the way that I can generously live and give to those around me in a God-honoring way. So I want to thank you for the money. I want to thank you for the devotional and for the training. But I also want to encourage anybody that has not gone through these trainings to go online, to sign up, to watch the video, and to even sign up for the devotional. It comes right to your email, so it's easy and accessible, but it's not too long, but it helps you shape your perspective and your mindset on money and how you live and how you do life to do it in a God-honoring way. So I want to encourage you with that, and I want to thank you, and I'm so excited to see what God has in store for the Eastern Region this year. So thank you.
We are so thankful for the generosity of the NAE and the Lilly Foundation. And pastors, you can receive a comprehensive financial plan through the Everence Financial Grant. Cost is just $200 for the pastor, and our grant will cover the balance of $1,000. This will go a long way to helping you plan for your future. I know for my wife and I, this was a tremendous experience, so I highly encourage you to take advantage of that grant opportunity.
Thanks, Ed. That's really good advice. Another resource for churches is the Development Fund, money that is available at a low interest loan to churches. Andy Black is a member of our finance and administration team, and he would like to tell us more.
Hi, everyone. My name is Andy Black, and I am the worship and administrative pastor at the other First Friends Church out in Salem, Ohio. I just wanted to take a few minutes and tell you about our experience with the Development Fund from EFCER. It has been a huge blessing to us. I'll tell you about our situation. We had about 4 years ago, we took on a loan at a bank for about $45,000 to redo our parking lot. And that percentage, that interest was something like 4.5, just north of 4.5, I believe. And then I found out about this development fund money that was available to any churches in the EFCER that wanted to do a project or needed some cash, less than $100,000. And I realized that we were in that ballpark, so I talked to Ed, and he said, sure, we could refinance that for you. And that was such a win-win for us. We got a really low interest rate, saved us a few percentage points on that, which is, you know, it's probably $1,000 or $2,000 over the course of the remaining life of that loan, when that's $1,000 or $2,000 that we can do other things with. And we're really excited about that. But I just think this development fund is a win-win for churches to be able to do things they wouldn't otherwise be able to do at a very low interest rate. I think it's a win for the denomination to be able to have something with that, you know, have that money go somewhere where it can really do a lot of good. And it's not just sitting there. It is at least when the churches are borrowing and paying a little bit of interest on that, they're, you know, the denomination wins on that too. So I think it's such a great setup that I want to make sure that you don't miss. If you have a project coming up, less than $100,000, or maybe you have a loan that is small enough to qualify for maybe some sort of refinance, just talk to Ed, and I'm sure he would love to talk to you about your situation and see how the EFCER can help you out with the development fund. So thanks.
Finally, we want to recognize an individual on our team who has worked tirelessly behind the scenes with pastors and church treasurers to help churches with their administration. Tim Keene is a gift to Eastern Region. He has served as a church administrator and is our resident expert on helping churches get their books, finances, and HR issues in order. Tim has made himself available to churches, often at no cost whatsoever, except maybe some gas and a meal. And he believes firmly this is an issue where churches need to excel in wisdom and grace. I want us to recognize Tim, and on behalf of our team, the churches who've already been helped, and all of Eastern Region, we want to say thank you.
Thank you, Tim.